Dit is Johan, dit is de man van Nalini Malani. Ik ga bij de weg wijzen. Kijk, drie hoog, we zijn aangekomen. We gaan aan het werk. Nalini, so we're here now in your house and your studio. We have this amazing work, Transgressions, from 2001. Can you tell me, but it's the first shadow play that you ever produced. Can you talk a bit about that, how that came about?
I had made a shadow play earlier on in 1999, or was it 98, without the video element, and that was made as a kind of a symbol for peace, because we had just had very bad riots in the city, and in order to create a sense of peace, I wanted to make Buddhist prayer wheels. And the shadow play was one way of trying to create a sense of peace, and they were low on the ground with just a light source. But then I thought about one more layering, which would be the video layering, and for Unpacking Europe, which was shown in Rotterdam at the Boymans van Berlin Museum, the brief from the curator, Salah Hassan, was Unpacking Europe. That was very interesting for me coming from India, because it was really about what it would mean for a country which had been through a whole period of colonization, and now it was the post-colonial period, and what would we be going through now. And the video element had to do with shadows forming on the body of a white man, like almost like a tattoo on the skin of a white man. The question of Orientalism. So it needed that extra layering. It was needed that this video would then speak about that. One more dimension, one more layering of the image. As long as I have, and I have a grip on what I have to say in the video, and what I have to say on the shadows in the cylinders, then the marriage comes together in its own logic. And I like very much the fact that it comes together in this marriage outside of myself. So this is what I find very exciting about working with the material video shadow play. And this is how this came about. But there's one more dimension to this. And that really began with when I started to make mylar cylinders. And it was actually in the theatre play called The Job, which is the story of Bertolt Brecht, which was made into a play in my project. And as we wanted to create different scenery without having blackouts, I decided to make cylinders the size of my performer. And the cylinders would go over her, and she would be transformed as a personage, depending on the dress that was in front of her. So it started as a style, material, all of that, because of the exigency of the theatre play. And therefore the word play continues in all these projects of mine, because I think the video shadow play is a theatrical experience.
It's also about globalization. Can you speak about that?
The text that you hear in Transgression has to do with the early times of globalization in India, where we suddenly had so many products that were available to people in the West. We had them in India as well. The other thing is the need to speak English, because with English then you can connect with the international community, and also in terms of getting a job, English was vital. So you have a little girl saying, my mother, she was so wise, I wanted to go to an English school, and she did put me in an English school. But the result of this is that we are losing our languages. Therefore, at the end of the cycle, you see a whole lot of different languages from India going into the ground as if it is rain lost into the earth. So these are the things that I wanted to express in this work, Transgressions, and connecting it to the post-colonial period was the very fact, this conduit was that on the one hand, of course, we have suffered 300 years of colonization by the British, but aligning oneself to global / imperial situations was also completely problematic. And I think that, I guess, as a moral stand, what I'd like to say is that consumerism is fine and well, but it needs intelligence, just like one's diet. You can't eat too much sugar. You have to decide exactly what is the best way to be healthy, physically and mentally. And therefore, I think consumerism itself is a bit like that. We have to be intelligent about what we consume and not get too much into the greed of things. And I think that's what's really problematic today as well in the world.